Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we're making this cute little teddy bear. This cute little guy is called the Trouble Teddy. I named him that because I had troubles with my computer one night, and I had to sit there and update and do a bunch of stuff with my computer, and while I was waiting for it to update, I needed something to fiddle with, so I came up with this little pattern here. And the thing that's different about him is his ears are crocheted right in place, right onto the head. We don't have to make them and sew them on. The limbs are chains that we make and sew together and then put those onto the bear. Little tail is crocheted right onto the bear. And with this basic pattern, you can make the koala, the frog, or the bear. The only difference between these guys here is where you put the ears. So on the side, they become koala ears, and up on top, they become frog eyes, and right about here becomes the bear. Now the koala, the only difference between these two is I add a little extra row on here, and of course I show you that in the video. So this video is in two parts. Part one, I'm going to show you the head and the body and how to stuff and shape the body. I don't leave anything out, so whatever you don't need, just fast forward, and whatever you need to see again, just use your rewind buttons. And like all my patterns here on YouTube, it comes with a full written pattern that can be printed off on my blog. This is about 2 or 3 pages long. The link to this pattern is in the description box below. So you need to print that off and then come on back and follow along. The yarn I'm using for this project is Red Heart Comfort yarn. Every single one of them was made with Red Heart Comfort yarn. The one red teddy bear that you saw was made with Red Heart Super Saver, and that was in cherry red. And I'm using 2 different hook sizes for the pattern. The head and the body are made with a 3.75, and the rest of the teddy bear is made with a 4.25. I'm also using a blunt end yarn needle. Again, there's a written pattern that can be printed off from my blog, and there's a supplies list in the written pattern. So I hope you have fun, and if you do make yourself a little trouble teddy, please post pictures on my Facebook page. I'd sure love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and have fun! The head and the body are worked in one piece, and we start right up here. On the top of the head, we work our way down to the bottom of the body. So you need a stitch marker. I just use a piece of yarn of a different color. And row one is a loop with 6 stitches. I'm going to show you how I do my loop. I prefer the magic ring. There's also another method called the chain 2 method. You'll find videos linked to both of those methods in the description box below. And I'll just show you the method I use right now, and if I go too fast, please use one of those videos in the description box below, and I go over the method very slowly. So I'm going to show you how I do my magic ring. I'm going to take the yarn tail, I'm going to wrap it around these 2 fingers here, twice. Then I'm going to hold that yarn tail in between my pinky and my thumb, and the working yarn in between my pinky and the thumb. I'm going to go through those 2 strings, yarn over and pull through those 2 strings. Yarn over and pull through. And there is my slip knot. Get ready to crochet on. Now I'm going to put 6 single crochets into this loop here. And I put my hook through both those yarn strings. Going through, yarning over and pulling that yarn through that loop. Yarn over and pull through. And that was one single crochet. I'm going to do 5 more of those. Going through the loop, yarn over and pull through the loop. Yarn over and pull through, and that was 2. Going through the circle, yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through, and that was 3. I'm going to do 3 more of those. 4, 5, and 6. Now we need to close up the loop. I'm just going to pull that yarn tail out of there, out of the way. Now I'm going to hold this end here in between my thumb and my finger, and I'm going to pull on either one of these strings to close up this loop. So I pull that one, doesn't work, so I'm going to use the other one. And now I need to pull on the yarn tail to get rid of this string here. And there was my loop with 6 stitches. And the stitches themselves look like V's. There's 2 loops in a stitch and they look like a V. And the first one to count is underneath this big loop here. There's 1,
two, three, four, five, and six. The stitches will be easier to see at the end of row two. Now we're going to put two single crochets in each one of these six stitches. When we go through the first stitch, make sure you go through both loops of the stitch. So push through, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through. And there was one single crochet in the first. Now we're going to go back in the same stitch we were just in and put another single crochet. And there was two single crochets in the first stitch. Now we're going to repeat that in the second one. Pushing through, making sure you go through both loops of your stitch. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. And there was a single crochet in the second stitch. Now we're going to go back in the same stitch we were just in and put another single crochet. And that was two single crochets into the second. Now we're going into the third stitch now. Push through. And there was one, going back in the same stitch, and there's two. Going into the fourth stitch now, putting two single crochets. There was one, and two. Going into the fifth one now, there's one, and two. And now last time for this row, two single crochets into that sixth stitch. There's one and two. And that's the end of row two, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'm going to add my marker now. I'm going to pull out that last stitch so I don't lose it. I'm just going to push right through that last stitch I just put in. Lay my yarn over the hook and pull it through, pulling one yarn tail through and leaving the other one hanging. And we're going to move this marker at the end of every row. This yarn tail, you can leave it hanging. We'll just tuck it into the piece as the piece gets a little bit bigger. You don't want to cut this free. If you cut it too short, it could work itself free and then you end up with a hole in your stuffy. If this circle here is too large, there's a big hole there, you can actually hold on to the piece and just pull on that yarn tail and close that circle up. So row three is one single crochet in the first stitch, two single crochets into the second, and then we're going to repeat that. One single crochet in the first, two single crochets into the second, and then keep repeating until we land on the marker. When we land on this marker, we'll be putting in two single crochets. So one single crochet in the first, and two single crochets into the second stitch. There's one, going back in the same stitch we were just in, and two. Now we're going to repeat that. One single crochet in the first. Make sure you go through both loops of your stitch. And two single crochets into the second stitch. There's one, and two. Now we're going to repeat that. One single crochet in the first. And two single crochets into the second stitch. Repeating that sequence, one in the first, and two into the second. Repeating, one in the first, and two into the second. Repeating for the last time, one in the first, and two is going to land on that marker, so we'll pull the marker out and put in our two single crochets. And that's the end of row three, and now we have 18 stitches around. Now if your piece is folding up on itself, like this, you want to make sure that you turn it right side. Where you, the starting yarn tail is coming out of, just push that inward. So this is the right side, and that is the wrong side. Right side. Wrong side. Now we're going to move our marker. Going through that last stitch we just put in and pull our marker through. Rows 4 through 7 is one single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for 4 rows. So you just put one single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for 4 rows. If you don't want to keep track of your rows as you're crocheting, each time you land on your marker, put a notch on your notepad. Each time you land on that marker and you move it, put a notch on your notepad. When you have 4 notches, we'll meet back here. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll leave you on your own now. One single crochet, each one of those 18 stitches for 4 rows. Make sure that you're going through both loops of your stitch each time you go through. And you can see the piece will start folding up on itself, completely normal. Just stop and push it right side. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 7. Alright, I just finished row 7. I'm going to show you how to do a row count. I'm going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. When you count your rows, always count behind the marker. Don't count in front of the marker. Always count behind. And we start by counting this first loop that we put in. And we're just going to count these rings. So I just finished row 7. I should have 7 rings. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. If you count in front of your marker, the way it dips down here, it's going to give you a different row count than you have. If you count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But it's just because of the way it dips down here. So always count behind your marker. Now we're going to move our marker, and we're going to start decreasing the head. Row 8 is one single crochet into the first, and then we're going to crochet 2 stitches together. And then we're going to repeat that all the way around, and when we land on the marker, we should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So one single crochet in the first, and now crochet these 2 stitches together. Go through that stitch and grab your yarn, pull it through. Leave that loop on your hook and go into the next stitch. Grab your yarn and pull it through. Now you have 3 loops. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And you just crochet 2 stitches together. Now we're going to repeat that sequence. One single crochet in the first. And then crochet 2 stitches together. Leave that loop on your hook and go into the next. You have 3 loops. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Now we're going to repeat that. One single crochet into the next. And then crochet 2 stitches together. We're just going to keep repeating the sequence all the way around. One single crochet, then 2 single crochets together. One single crochet, and now crocheting those 2 stitches together, it's going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out and crochet those 2 stitches together. And that's the end of row 8, and now we have 12 stitches around. Tuck that starting yarn tail inside, get it out of my way, and move my marker. Row 9, we're going to repeat the last row, one single crochet in the first, and then crochet 2 together. So if you're starting to see gaps in your work and it's not going away even if you tighten up your stitches, I'm going to show you how to eliminate those. One single crochet in the first. So if you're seeing gaps, now we're going to crochet these 2 together but using the front loops only. So there's 2 loops in your stitch. There's the back loop, that's the one furthest from you, and then there's the front loop, and that's the one closest to you. So crochet the 2 front loops together. Leave that loop on your hook and go into the next front loop. You have 3 and pull through. Now we're going to repeat that. One single crochet in the first and then crochet 2 together. When you do the one single crochet, you're going through both loops. And if you're seeing gaps, you're going to go through the front loops only. And I'm going to repeat that again. It's going to flatten out this piece, getting harder to work with because it's getting smaller and smaller. One single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together. I'm going to go through the front loops. If you're not seeing gaps in your work, don't worry about this part. You can just crochet right through both loops of your stitches. One single crochet in the first. Now those two together is going to land in the marker, so pull it out and go through those two front loops. I'm going to move my marker. That's the end of row 9, and now we have 8 stitches around. Row 10 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches. So you can see the hole is getting quite small, so it's a little bit more difficult to work in. When the hole is this small, it's very easy to go back in those last stitches you just put in or crocheted 2 together. Very easy to go back in there, so make sure you're going into the first stitch of the row. Just pull it back and look. And if you can't tell what you're doing, turn it towards you and look for the V of your next stitch and go through there. We're going to put 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches. There's one. I'm going back in the same stitch we were just in. There's 2. Going into the next stitch now. 2 single crochets. There's 1 and 2. And remember, if I'm going too fast, just pause me and catch up. And once you're caught up, start the video again. Now 2 single crochets in the next. And now 2 single crochets into the next. 1 and 2. And 2 single crochets into the next. 1 and 2. Two into the next. And then the last time, pull out the marker and 2 single crochets into that last stitch. Move your marker. That's the end of row 10, and now we have 16 stitches around. They are a little bit bunched up now, so you just got to make sure in the next row that you're getting into the right stitch, so take your time. Always take your time. Row 11 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. So 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet into the 2nd stitch, 1 single crochet into the 3rd, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. There's 1, and going back to the same stitch, there's 2. Now I'm going to repeat that. 1 single crochet into the 1st, 1 single crochet into the 2nd stitch, 1 single crochet into the 3rd, and 2 single crochets into the 4th. Now you're going to keep repeating that sequence. One in the 1st, one in the 2nd, one in the 3rd, and then 2 into the 4th. And repeat for the last time. One in the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 2 into the 4th. That's the end of row 11, and now we have 20 stitches around. I'm going to pull out my last stitch so I don't lose it. I'm going to stuff the head now, so just pull out your marker. And you can see the head does not look like this. You have to stuff it to look like this and shape it as you stuff. So just get your stuffing in there. And then push it to the sides. making sure to get all under this area here. Just push it in with your finger. You can see I put a lot of stuffing in there. You should have put stuffing all in this area here. You just make sure you just, when you push the stuffing in, that you're pushing it to the sides, all around here. Okay, once you're happy with that, we can continue on. Move the marker. Row 12 is one single crochet in the next three stitches, and then two single crochets into the fourth, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in two single crochets. I'll do the first set with you, and then I'll leave you on your own. One single crochet in the first, one single crochet in the second, one in the third, and then two single crochets into the fourth. And now you're going to repeat that sequence. One single crochet in the next three, and then two into the fourth. Repeat all the way around. We'll meet back here when you land on the marker. Remember, when you land on the marker, you should be putting in two single crochets. I'll finish row 12, and we should have 25 stitches around. You can do a stitch count. You just pull out your last stitch so you don't lose it. First stitch to count is underneath this big loop, and it's that V. Looks like the V. There's one, two, and you count the V's all the way around. And the last one to count is in front of this knot right here. Okay, so make sure you move your marker. Now we're going to start decreasing. Row 13 is one single crochet in the next three stitches, and then we're going to crochet two together. And remember, if you start seeing gaps, you can crochet the two together in the front loops only. So let's do the first set together. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now crochet two together. You can go through both loops if you'd like. We'll do one more set together. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and if you're seeing gaps, crochet the two together in the front loops only. Now you're going to repeat that sequence all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. One single crochet in the next three, then two together. Repeat all the way around. We'll meet back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 12, and now we have 20 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Row 13, we're going to repeat the last row. One single crochet in the next three stitches, then two together. And then you repeat that sequence all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. There was two, and three, and now two together. And remember, if you're seeing gaps, to just crochet the two front loops together. And hopefully that will take care of those gaps. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. One single crochet in the next three, then two together. Repeat all the way around. I'll finish row 14, I've moved my marker, and now we have 16 stitches around. Row 15 is the last row that we're going to crochet. We're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches, and then crochet two together, repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two together. So again, remember, you don't want to go back in the last stitches you just crocheted together. Very easy to do, so don't do that. Make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the next row. One single crochet in the next two stitches, then crochet two together. And remember, if you're seeing gaps, to crochet in the front loops only. I'll continue on the pattern, reach back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 15, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'm going to finish off, so I'm just going to pull out that last stitch so I don't lose it, and finish off. I'm going to cut free, leaving a bit of a tail to sew up that gap. Pull that yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. Now we're going to weave in and out of these remaining stitches. Instead of pushing the end of your yarn through your yarn needle, bend it over and push the bend through. When we weave in and out, we're going to weave in and out of the front loops only. So go through the front loops, in and out. So there, I've weaved in and out all those front loops of the remaining stitches, and I can pull on this to close up this gap, but before we do that, we have to stuff the body, of course. So again, we're going to do this just like we did the head, shaping the body as we stuff, with all the stuffing in there. It'll take quite a bit, this little guy takes quite a bit of stuffing. And if you have troubles, just use a pen or the back end of a pencil. Push that stuffing in there. Now I'm going to close up this gap a little bit, just to hold that stuffing in, and I'm going to get more stuffing in there through that little bit of a hole there. Use a little bit more there. I'm going to use my pen to shove all the stuffing around in this area here. So you can see I put quite a bit of stuffing in there, and I shaped it with my pen. I got a big head and a nice fat little body. Now we can pull on that yarn tail and close it right up. Pull tight. Now we need to knot this off. We're just going to pick a stitch close by, go through it. Before we pull it all the way, just go through that loop and then pull tight. Now we can bring this through the body and out through a stitch anywhere. Pull through, pull on it slightly, and cut. And the yarn tail is safely hidden away